Hey there. In this video, I'm going to show you how I go about color grading my videos. There's color grading, which some of you might have heard of, and there's color correction. Color correction is where you correct colors, obviously, between scenes. So if you're shooting on camera, or maybe, you know, one of these latest games, the colors will change between scenes, and you may want to keep kind of the mood the same. Color grading is basically where you give a particular character, or a particular mood to a video by editing the colors. So here's two clips from Colors of War that I still have on my computer. So I'll bring one in here, and this is the first clip, as you might know, and you can see I still have some of the elements on the screen. And this was captured at 2144 by 1206. This allows me to get a 1920 by 800 resolution in this top right here. So this was using cropping, but I forced my monitor to render a much larger resolution in order to get that particular frame size. So I'm going to go ahead and crop this so it gives us a better idea of what we're looking for. So we're at 800 pixels. I'll just set this to 800 right here. And 1920. Alright, that's our frame right there. Looks nice. Okay, so Battlefield Bad Company 2 Vietnam is kind of a bland color palette. It's mostly blues and greens with a little bit of gold in some areas. So by color grading, you can bring out that saturation, that color that's hidden in those gray tones. So I'm going to open up an effects palette, and I have two filter packages, basically preset sets of effects that I used for most of my stuff, and I start from there. These are custom ones that I made. They're not just ones in the program. And this is similar to what Colors of War looked like. I made this preset actually after making the video because I wanted to save it. So this is a little bit, it's very golden, it's very yellow. I think it feels very inviting. You may be thinking, but all I do is video games, why should you care? If a video feels inviting, people are more likely to sit through it and watch it. It's not just about having flashy effects. Most of the stuff I do is to make the video look very appealing and worth checking out. That's how I draw, I think, viewers in, is because I try to make the video look very nice and clean. So if I switch off the video, you can see the difference right there. So all I did is two effects. Color curves, which is a very smooth form of contrast. Basically, it's a slight S, is what many people refer to it as. And you can just bring down, turn this off here, bring down the lower bar, which pulls down the dark levels, but it's ramped up to the top here, so it's very smooth, it's not very harsh. And you can notice, because of the letterbox here, you can see where black is. This is zero, effectively. But the tree here still has a little bit of brightness in it, and that's okay. You don't necessarily always want everything to be from 0 to 255. You know, you may see some kind of, I don't know if this is a word, lomographic photos. Basically, lomography it was a form of photography from a company, and it was very high saturation, high contrast. But sometimes the black colors and the white colors wouldn't actually be pure white. They would sometimes be this kind of dark gray. And that gave a lot of character to the video, and it's, if you notice it, you'll see it a lot in indie films probably, because that's probably a good source for film-like-ish visuals. So with the color corrector, I'm actually tinting this gray here, and it's sort of like a dark red or burgundy. And I think that is a nice style. Now, it may seem kind of hipster, I don't know, but when I'm doing my footage, I like to have that really warm low tones most of the time. For my Minecraft videos, I actually mostly went the opposite. I actually wouldn't use a color corrector. I'd use another curves here. Let's get curves. And I would go in between the channels. So this is, we already have contrast. And on this one, I'll go to the red channel, bring down the reds, so it's making it bluer, but then I'll bump up the reds in the highlights, so it makes it kind of a red sky. Then the green channel, I'll bring it down just a little bit, and then I'll bring it up a little bit in the highlights, so it makes it kind of a yellow sky. Then for blue, I'll bring the blue up in the lowlights, and then bring it down the sky. So all these counteract to give a warm sky. Let's see if we can bring this out a little more. And cool lowlights. Because the dark areas of Minecraft are almost always going to be stone or gravel or coal. And those we kind of subconsciously associate with being cold. So I was sort of just following that. And the warm trees and the sky and all that is kind of going to be yellow or orange or red. So I kind of did that already. So you can see the difference. It's almost like we're flipping the color palette. And so I didn't really affect the contrast using this. I only affected which colors and which luminosities were the most sort of prioritized. So I'm going to go back to color corrector. And that's basically it. There's no... You can see here as well. Let's just crop this. That's all there is to color grading. It's giving a particular look for video. So let's say we wanted something maybe completely different. I'm going to reset this. You can see there's different presets here. Let's see if we can create something really interesting with this. So I'm going to go into color curves. I'm going to bring down the brightness a lot. Let's see if we can make it kind of depressing. All right. Make it kind of cinema, filmish. And then we'll bring in levels. I'm going to flatten the highlights. That's really weird. So, that's before, that's after. It's worth experimenting with. I like the preset I used. I shouldn't say preset. I made the preset myself, so I don't really count it against anyone. That's it for this. It's pretty much the same for After Effects or Premiere Pro if it has a color curves tool. It's just a matter of playing with different channels and different brightness levels. So that's how I went about color grading, colors of war, and a small part of the Minecraft minecart interstate videos. It's really simple. It's not anything really complex. So I hope that kind of alleviates any confusion. Thanks for watching.